The name Stan Schultz may not light up the marquee at your local movie theater, but chances are you've seen him on the big screen.
Well, back in 1970, I joined the group of reenactors for Fort Ransom Cavalry. Well, from that, there was the individuals that were responsible for bringing in extras for Dances with Wolves was familiar with our group and wanted to bring us in on that. And so, you know, we had the military presence and equipment and protocol, and then doing the movie, it was just running through the numbers and doing what we do. And it was really quite successful for the movie industry to have reenactors that knew what to do when you give the direction to one individual and then he shouts out the commands to the company.
And not too long after that, the movie business soon became a family affair.
I was in the fourth grade when I got to go on my first movie. It was Crazy Horse, a TNT production. It was a pretty big deal. I was pretty popular back at school. The big actress on that one was Irene Bedard, who had done, that was the voice of Pocahontas that just came out, the Disney voice of her. And so I got autographs for all the class and the teachers and everything. And so yeah, it was a pretty big deal for me at that time.
And after a few more appearances on the small and big screens, Stan was presented a chance to increase his footprint in Hollywood.
In 2006, the British BBC came over to shoot Custer's Last Stand. And they were needing horses for the actors for that particular film. And the guy that was the coordinator for the project called me up, and it's a gentleman that I work with quite a bit, Jim Hatzell, out of Rapid City, and he asked if I would supply the horses for the actors. So that went quite well.
Come here, buddy.
And the work for Schultz Wrangling keeps evolving.
It kind of turned into more of the horse work with the wrangling, bringing the horses in for the actors. And even, you know, even in the last couple of years, it's changed more into, in addition to what we're doing with the horses, the stunt work and character parts here and there that we get thrown into just because we got the right look for something they're looking for. So between all of it, it's we've known the business, it's just we've gotten to do different things within the business. It's been kind of fun to see as well.
But some of the toughest parts is training the actors themselves.
It's the one thing that we've had is real fortunate with all the different actors is that we usually build a pretty good rapport with them. You know, part of their safety and health is in our hands. And so, you know, you got to build that relationship with the actors and actresses and such. So, and you got some that are just absolutely scared of horses. And, you know, you got to try to get them over that fear.
The actors aren't the only ones. Need a little bit of training, too.
As training the horses, have to give them, you know, some scenarios that try to rattle them. If they do rattle, we've had horses that, you know, perfect-looking horse, great-looking horse, and it's scared of everything. And, you know, until we get in there and start doing our action with them, we don't know what's going to happen. And then once we find out, then we can take them out onto the set.
And with the new family business starting to boom, that left the question whether the Schultz family would be leaving the family ranch outside of Redfield for the bright lights of Hollywood.
You know, we're a small town. This is home for us. You know, we've got a lot of contacts all over the world, people we've met. But it's just kind of fun to be able to come back home after you go out and do these fun projects all over and still be a small town person.